Running quickly, faster. Are we rolling?
Secretly
rolling. I like that. Erica Blackwell, producer and host for YBL TV. What is that?
Your Biz Live TV. We are an internet TV show. I'm one of the hosts featured. We interview business owners from all different verticals: consumer electronics, hardware, software, design, automotive, you name it. And we're here at the NEB show having a great time finding out about some new booths. I love it.
So you cover the gamut of business industry from entertainment to commercial and beyond.
Yeah, even the coverings show.
Nice, I like that. So how many years have you covered NEB?
Oh gosh, I think about 2 or 3 now.
Okay, and what is different this year over previous years?
I'm staying out later.
I like that. She's staying out later. Hold it. I have to ask. You know, sometimes, like, I have this earpiece in, and it's not a teleprompter. It's just my Bluetooth that I forget to pull out sometimes. And I'm curious, who's talking in your headphones?
No one. I'm just following up from another phone call. So many great booths. Last night we were at La Scala restaurant. I was interviewing some people there. We had a great interview with Wii Video. Awesome company. Allows you to do editing up in the cloud. Loved it.
Nice. And what do you think are some of the highlights of this show when you walk away that you'll remember and also use on your own show?
I got to get cooking.
Nice. It's going to be a food show.
Oh, I got to get cooking. I mean, we just came from the nightclub and bar show. And then after...
Hold it. You just came from the nightclub and bar show at 11 in the morning?
That was just a couple of weeks ago. And now we're going to the Interrupt show, the money show. Where else are we going?
I want to come with you to the money show. I don't know about the rest of them, but I want to be the money show.
Yeah, the money show, the hardware show. That's a good show, the tailgate show. And San Francisco, we're interviewing a bunch of top women executives in California.
Wow, how powerful. So when are you going to be in Los Angeles?
Probably mid, late summer, early fall.
When you get there, let me know, because I have a group you should check out that's strictly media and entertainment professionals, all cities. And they actually meet on the lots at Paramount and Universal, and it's people who are in the industry networking on their projects and ideas. Something you might be interested in.
Rock on!
So, as you go forward in this convention, what are some things that are sticking out? I'm seeing myself a lot of new technologies and companies from all over the planet.
Well, I think, and I've got a lot on my mind, as you can see here, but from what I've at least just done my initial research...
Somebody cue the people with breakfast.
Yeah. From my initial research from this show, I think what's just been the trend that I've seen in the last year, 2 years, you've got Live View, you've got Streambox, so many other mobile devices or that allow you to stream just on the fly with your backpack and mobile ENG, whatever. I love it. I think it's great. I think what I'm really concerned about is content, legal issues, copyright, all that stuff, because it's like you're using this content, that content, you're combining it, you're mashing it up, and there's so many issues. We're talking with a law firm in Chicago and trying to resolve some of our legal issues that we're coming across with our show, and I tell you, it's not easy. They're at a stump. So we're here today to take some classes with Jeff Henninger, who's going to be talking about some of the legal issues, which hopefully we'll be able to address with him.
What's interesting is when you call a business, some of the people you cover and work with, they usually have this recording saying, this call may be monitored and recorded for training and integrity or whatever.
There's no privacy.
Thank you. We need to change the disclaimer. Your life is being monitored and recorded. Get used to it.
Yeah, there's no privacy. None. I mean...
People can have a channel on the internet and be uploading stuff as they walk down the street nowadays. You never know when people do things that are out of the norm that it's going to end up somewhere and come back to haunt you.
Yeah, I totally agree. But at the same time, it gives the power back to the people. I think that's really amazing. I mean, I was out in LA trying to bang down some doors there and work as an actor. And, you know, there's politics. There's a lot of politics, you know, and coming in at the right time. It's timing and who works best with you. And so I think I'm really happy because this gives me a voice, a medium, a platform to really help me shine, hopefully, and learn about new things and give other companies the opportunity to show their stuff and give them a platform. I think it's just wonderful. Chad Hurley couldn't have said it better. We're at an amazing time in history that companies are finally having the opportunity to take the power in their hands and you know, broadcast live anywhere in the world.
And don't blink. That's how fast it's going today. In 5 minutes, it's going to change.
I totally agree.
Very nice to meet you. Have a great show, Erica Blackwell.
Thank you so
I'm
much.
Kurt Kelly from Actors Reporter and Live Video Inc. We'll be back with more from NAB 2012. What I'd like to ask you to do is just do a quick bumper.
Hi, Dennis.
Quick bumper with your name and company. Hi, how are you?
I'm Erica Blackwell with Erica Live on Your Biz Live TV. I'll try that again. I'm so tired. Erica Blackwell with Erica Live on YBL TV. That's Your Biz Live TV. We're here at the NAB show. I am interviewing with Kurt from the Actors. Kurt Kelly, Actors Reporter. I'm Erica Blackwell with Erica Live on YBL TV. We're here at the NAB show. I'm here with Kurt Kelly with the Actors. Actors Reporter. Jesus Christ.
It's on the thing in front of you. We can do it. It's in your hat.
Excuse my language. I'm Erica Blackwell with Erica Live on Your Biz Live TV. That's YBL TV for short. We're here at the NAB show. I'm with the Actors Reporter, helping out, giving them some words of wisdom. All right, is this a bumper or what? I'm Erica Blackwell with Erica Live on YBL TV. We're here at the NAB show, and I'm interviewing with Kurt Kelly from the Actors Reporter. All right.
God bless you. That's quite all right. If you send me an email, I'll send you a link to where it's going to be and when
okay.
and everything.
Did you come to a radio show?
Yes, I did. Yeah, Dennis.
Yeah. Well, good
How
to see
you.
Been? Yeah, I'm doing great. So, yeah. So, this is a little bigger show than a radio show.
Oh, yeah. Well, no, yeah, I've been here before.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I'm just, it's so much fun.
It is fun. It is.
She should be like a cheerleader for NAB.
It's survival for the staff. Just get through this thing. But it is fun. It's impressive to see.
One of my most favorite shows.
Great. I'm glad
Yay.
You're having fun.
Very nice to meet you.
Bye,
Please
Kurt.
Stay in touch
okay.
and let me know when you get to LA.
Perfect.
I'll hook you up with that. All right, cool.
So
just grabbing some random people and then we're going to go back in and get some more of the displays and stuff.
Perfect.
And we wanted
you
to shoot Betty White. Yeah, but they wouldn't let us shoot.
Oh, really?
Yeah, they told them to put the camera away. So is there any way we could get some footage from you?
There should be some footage. Come up to the newsroom and see if we've got any.
Okay.
I don't know if we did.
Because I don't know why they told us. I wasn't actually here because I had to be somewhere else.
I should know the answer to that.
And they told them no shooting of that event. Is that true of all the major events?
Well, you're
like
not allowed
Gary
to
Marshall?
Stream it. And but you're allowed to do
we
snippets,
recording.
I think.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was my understanding we could shoot the event for as long as we wanted.
Yeah.
We could only use 5 minutes of the clip.
I think that's true.
And we had to put it up in 3 days.
I think that is supposed to be the case unless they've changed the rules. Which,
interesting.
So, yeah. Anyway.
Okay. You ready? I'm Kurt Kelly. What? Yeah, he said go up to the newsroom and tell them that he sends you and that maybe they can get you some footage clips we can use.
Yeah, and I could be wrong on that. Maybe I should know the answer to that, but the woman who was just here with me would know the answer to that.
And what's her name?
Anne Marie Cummings.
Anne Marie Cummings.
Yeah.
Anne Marie Cummings, if when you go up there, ask for Anne Marie.
Yeah.
Okay, you rolling? I'm Kurt Kelly from Live Video Inc., an actor's reporter, and we're at the NAB 2012, and we're with Dennis Wharton, who is the Executive Vice President for NAB?
Correct, Vice President of Communications.
And from Ohio, I might add, being
originally,
from Michigan.
Originally, but D.C. now lasts for the last 30 years or so, so I guess I've got Potomac fever now.
Love that. Now, NAB stands for National Association of Broadcasters.
Right.
I know that since being in entertainment and broadcasting since 10, I remember that.
Right.
But you've been around a lot longer than I have.
Yeah.
as a organization.
Right. We started in 1923, actually, and focusing on copyright issues, and ironically, we're still fighting copyright issues in Washington, but obviously the first NAB show was a little smaller than this in New York in 1923, but we've been coming to Vegas now every year since 1991 because people just love coming to Las Vegas after a cold winter and back east, and people from all over the globe come here. We've got more than 90,000 people, 156 countries represented, about a third of the attendees are from outside the United States,
wow.
So that talks and speaks to the sort of the global brand of the NAB show. But it's a lot of fun. We've thrown a little entertainment, excitement. We had Betty White for breakfast this morning. We had James Cameron for the director of the Titanic and Avatar talking about 3D. So
Gary Marshall's coming up tomorrow, I believe.
Gary Marshall was yesterday. Got inducted into our Hall of Fame. He's the producer of Laverne and Shirley and Happy Days and Pretty Woman. So Bob Uecker, the baseball announcer, is getting inducted into the Radio Hall of Fame at our radio luncheon this afternoon. And Donny Osmond's going to be
at lunch. So this is just a lineup of one celebrity after another.
Yeah.
But that's what the entertainment industry is about.
Right.
You've expanded your reach domestically as well as globally, beyond radio, beyond television.
Yeah.
How are you going to be impacting or impacted by internet?
Well, sorry
I asked that question.
Yeah, we look at it as an opportunity to expand our revenue base, to network with potential new business partners. And the NAB show floor, if you walk on it, you just see football field after football field of technology companies from Sony and Microsoft to mom and pop startups. We'll have almost 200 new exhibitors this year. So every year we lose a few exhibitors, but we gain a couple hundred more. So it's an organic show. It sort of evolves every year with new companies who have new ideas, and some of them become the next Microsoft down the road. But so that's what's really cool about the show is it's constantly evolving and constantly changing. But the business opportunities are great right now with the internet and social media, and but broadcasting can be a part of that.
Well, and broadcasting has expanded so much beyond terrestrial broadcasts.
Absolutely.
That people were used to. I'm listening to my local radio station, whether it be WLS in Chicago or KHJ,
right,
or WABC in New York, just to name drop a couple.
Right.
But now it's also satellite. It's 5,000 cable channels.
Sure.
It's internet all over the place.
Right.
What is the position of the NAB on piracy?
We're against piracy. We're against copyright thieves. But there are opportunities sometimes for companies who want to take our product,
right,
if they do it legally, and we can maybe have a business relationship. So if you're just taking our product and putting it out on the internet and streaming it illegally, we're going to have a real problem with that.
Thank you.
But the theme of the show is the great content shift. So we do want to get broadcasting on as many platforms as we possibly can. That's smartphones, that's tablets, that's in the back seats of cars, Android for sure. So this is not your father's broadcasting business.
Not anymore.
We have to be on mobile devices and sort of meeting the on-the-go demands of people who want to get their content on all of these new mobile devices, and we're doing that.
I flash when you say not your mom and pop's thing anymore. I was having dinner with Mike McVeigh, who you may know.
Sure,
and I know Mike from days back in Michigan and Ohio,
right,
and Mike is now heading programming for Cumulus, and he,
right,
told me this story how the family that owns the Cumulus Group now,
right,
started with one FM radio station in Toledo back in the late,
right,
70s, and now they have the second largest, most powerful radio broadcast group,
indeed,
in the world.
Lou Dickey is a NAB board member and a good friend of mine, and they have built an incredible company, and
yes,
after Clear Channel, they are the number two largest radio company in the country. So I think that speaks to a company that is smart and creative, and it shows that in America anything's possible.
That people can grow. Right. So when you were talking about you want to have people get involved in content, there are people who believe when I download that song or that television show, I'm just playing it at home, it's no big deal. But if those were the same people who owned a store and I went and picked up a stereo and walked out, they'd have a problem with it.
Yeah.
How do we educate people that this is maybe $150 billion represented here today, but the real reality is maybe it's $500 billion if people started paying for what they're receiving?
Yeah, I think younger people do have this perception that if it's available, I ought to have it for free.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I'm a former journalist, and I've seen what's happened to the journalism business.
Newspapers.
Newspapers are dying because people think they don't have to pay for that content. Now, some papers are putting their content behind a paywall and experimenting on whether you can replace the analog dollars with more than just digital dimes, as they say.
Right, right.
So it's a problem with younger people to understand that copyright needs to be protected if you want to have a thriving entertainment industry.